सनिश्चयेन योक्तव्यो योगो अनिर्विण्ण चेतसा संकल्प प्रभवान कामांस त्यक्त्वा सर्वान शेषतः मनसैवेन्द्रिय ग्रामं विनियम्य समं ततः. सो हियर कृष्णा एंड दिस एक्चुअली इन द सिक्स्थ चैप्टर कृष्णा डज अ सॉर्ट ऑफ ascent descent alteration between the sadhana stage and the siddha stage, and each of these alterations he takes the description of the siddha stage higher and the explanation of the sadhana stage deeper. So for example, when initially he starts with shuchodeshe pratishthapya, he's talking primarily about externals. Okay, go and sit in a particular place, secluded place, and sit in the asana. And from there, he goes from the 10th verse to the 15th verse. He goes to the perfection where he says that yogin yitasaptam, vinjane evam sadatmana, yogin yata manasa, shantin nirvana parma, matsamstham adhigachi. They attain my nature. And then Krishna again, so this is like, at one level, they attain my nature. That is one level of yogic perfection, or one phase of the description of yogic perfection. Then from there, Krishna goes back again to the sadhaka stage, and he talks about yukta natyashnutasu yogosthi and yukta aviharasya, how one has to be regulated in one's eating, sleeping, and other things. And from there, he moves onwards to the state of perfection of yoga, which was described till the 23rd verse, yam labdhva chaparam labham, and all that, where one having achieved this, there's nothing more to achieve. Now again, Krishna is in one sense going down to the sadhana stage, sanishchayena yoktavyo. Therefore, one should act with determination, with nishchaya, determination. And from here, Krishna will go to the perfection stage. And when he goes to the perfection stage, it will be a much more devotionally explicit perfection stage, where yo maam pashyati sarvatra, that very direct devotional verse will come in 6.30. So essentially, Krishna, by this alteration, is doing two things. He is going deeper in his description of the sadhana, and he is going higher in his description of the sadhya. Let's see. So how does this happen? First, he talked about just in the first description of sadhana, he talked more about externals. You know, just go to this place and sit in the, go to a secluded place and sit, create, make asana and things like that. Then afterwards, he talked about more of habits that one should have. Habits of the body. Eat regulatedly. Sleep regulatedly. Now Krishna is going to talk about, again for the sadhaka stage, more of managing the inner battle. Of course, this has been talked about earlier also. But here Krishna's focus comes more explicitly on that. Sanishchayena yoktavyo. Sanishchayena. With nishchay, with determination. Yogo anirvinna chetasam. Therefore, yoga should be practiced with anirvinna chetasa, without any anirvinna. Anirvinna can refer to dejection, or it can refer to distraction. So, of course, dejection can also be a form of distraction, but distractions can be of various forms. So now, that means don't get distracted. Practice yoga with determination. So why may one get distracted? Because there are so many distractions in this world, and there are so many distractions in the mind also. And also, apart from that, there is also a dejection that can happen, because when one tries to practice yoga, the path of yoga is not very easy to follow. And one may meet with failure, disappointments, and if the disappointments happen repeatedly, then one may become dejected also. So Krishna is saying, don't become dejected like this. So, anirvinna chetasa. Now, if we connect this with the previous thought that was mentioned, these two could also become one continuous verse. Then also we see a deep, nice meaning here. Krishna gives the summation, gives the perfection of one level of perfection of the yogi stage, when he says that dukkha sanyoga viyoga yoga sangitam. That yoga will actually give disconnection from the connection with misery. That will give end of misery. So now, the end of misery is definitely a glorious goal. especially for one who is miserable, just like a person who is sick with a serious disease and is in pain, and the doctor says, follow this treatment properly and you will become free from disease. And is okay, 3 months down the line, you will be free from this disease. And therefore, don't get dejected. So, do this, like that. In the previous state, Krishna stated that dukkha sanyoga viyoga, this will happen. And therefore, because that is going to happen, sanishchayena yoktavyo, therefore engage yourself in determination. And determination means rejection of dejection. Determination means that we say no to saying, no, I can't do it. Often when we become dejected, that means, no, it's too difficult. I have too many conditionings in my circumstances. There are too many obstacles or whatever. I can't do it. So determination means to say no to the statement, I know I can't do it. No, I will not say like this. I will not think like this. I will never become dejected. Anirvinna chetasa. I will keep my consciousness. I will not let my consciousness get dejected. Chetasa. Anirvinna. Sanishchayena. No. What is the basis for the nishchaya? Krishna says that, at the end, there is the end of sorrow. There is the end of misery that you are going to get. It's definitely a worthwhile goal. And just like when we know that what we are going to achieve is worthwhile, is glorious, then we are eager to pursue it. So like that, Krishna is telling over here to Arjuna that please pursue this because you are going to achieve something glorious by this. You will achieve the cessation of misery and therefore be determined. And then overcoming that distraction or dejection entail, that he mentions in the next part of the verse. Sankalpa prabhavan kamam styaktva sarvana sheshataha. So, sankalpa prabhavan kamams. So, kamams are material desires for worldly enjoyment. Sankalpa prabhavan. So the desire for enjoyment, when it translates into an intention for enjoyment, then it becomes nearly irreversible. Because once we decide to do something, then that means the internal guards against our wrongdoing have already been devastated. Now, intelligence is our inner guard against wrongdoing. But when we decide to do something wrong, that means that inner guard has been devastated. Just like if an enemy is going to attack and there is one particular wall which is meant to hold the enemy back. But if the enemy has come to the second wall, that means the first wall has already been penetrated. So like that, our intelligence is the guarding wall between temptation and intention. We feel tempted to do something, but then it's not that we have to do it. And we can say no to it. But when we say yes to it and then we decide to do it, then that is the level where it becomes a temptation, becomes an intention. And Krishna is telling over here that don't let the desires for enjoyment become sankalpas. Don't let them become intentions. So rather, when the desires, they are about to become intentions, before that itself, tyaktva sarvana sheshataha, give them up without any exception. Tyaktva sarvana sheshataha. Without any exception. Krishna has earlier talked in the second chapter about how even one of the senses can cause fall down. Indriyanam icharatam yan mano anuvidhyate dasya harati pragyam vayurnavamivambhase. So Indriya, even one of the senses, if it is roaming, then that can cause the person to be carried away. So like that, so the Krishna is saying here, even one desire can cause distraction, therefore give up all desires for worldly enjoyment. And now for a yogi, has decided to give up the world and turn towards the other world. Naturally, the desires have to be given up. Now for us, we as bhaktas, we dovetail our desires. We give up the sinful desires and we dovetail those desires which are devotionalizable, which can be dovetailed with devotion. Taktva manasaivendriya gramam miniyamya samantataha. Manasaivendriya gramam means that manasa, with the mind, eva suddenly indriya gramam, all the senses, niyamya samantataha, carefully keep them under control. With the mind, control the senses on all sides. Niyamya samantataha, samantataha means in all ways, on all sides, on all forums. So don't let the senses engage in sense gratification. So now, in one sense, Krishna in the previous line of this is Sankalpa Brahmantamas, Tektva Sarvana Asheshataha. There is also the whole scope of Ashesh. The sense of on all fronts is conveyed in this by Samantataha, and the previous half of those is conveyed by Asheshataha. That means what is Krishna saying over here? That from the mind, don't let there be any desires, and that is internal cleansing and outer. With the mind, control the senses so that there is no outer indulgence also. So, just like when we are fighting a war and say there are invaders outside a fort. Now, if they can just break down one gate and come in, you know, that can prove fatal. Because once they get in, they can devastate. The fort is the defense. So here, by this statement, Krishna is pointing out that there should be no, don't leave any holes for the enemy to exploit. Just do it. Just to make sure, just do it in the sense that just be thorough in ensuring that there are no opportunities. So don't keep desires internally. Taktva sarvana sheshata, and Viniyamya indriyagramam viniyamya samantata. So in this way, by the less we leave the possibility for fall, then the less is the probability of fall. We don't leave the possibility only, then the probability becomes zero. So that way, Krishna is telling that one can avoid rejection. So the flow of the verse is that in the previous verse it said that yoga is so glorious that it will free you from all misery. Therefore, practice it with determination and without distraction or rejection. Now, whatever causes distraction or rejection, that is, the desires internally, give them up. And what causes distraction? The senses which receive images and sense objects that trigger desires. This is control the senses also externally. And all of this, on all sides, samantataha. So in this way, by being vigilant in guarding the territory of our consciousness from intruders who are actually invaders in terms of desires or in terms of sensory perception that will stimulate desires. So by that, we as seekers can stay fixed on this devotional path, on the spiritual path, and ultimately attain spiritual perfection. Thank you.